Today we're going to learn how to make a modular origami spinning toy. It's really easy to make. You just need 6 sheets of square pieces of paper. I've taken an ahead of time cut mine, but I'll show you how to get yours. You can take fold the full sheet of paper so it lines up nice and evenly along that edge, and then you got an extra flap up here. But you're going to want to take some scissors, get an adult to help you if you're a child, and cut all the way along there, and then you'll end up with a square sheet of paper. And then what I like to do is take one of the sheets, put it on top of a stack taken, grab a pen, mark it off, and then take your scissors and cut along that line. And that way you end up with a whole bunch of them. Don't do too many at once. If you do, the papers won't stay straight and they'll move around as you cut down through thicker layers, and they'll move around and you won't get an even edge. You'll get different layers that have different lengths as you cut along. So only do, say, 10 sheets at a time or something like that. Don't do much more than that. Too thick, like I said, it moves it around and it makes it so you don't get straight cuts. So we're done with the scissors. We got our square sheets of paper. We're going to take 6 of them. So we want 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So 6 pieces of paper, square. Now, you want to take, you're going to do the same for all of them, I believe. You're going to take, fold it right in half. Nice and even. The more even your folds are, the more better your end product will be. You want to unfold it. You want to make the crease down the center. Now you want to fold it the other way. Make sure it's nice and even. Then you want to unfold it. Now you got 2 center lines, creases down the centers both ways. You want to take the bottom right corner and fold it up to the top right corner. Nice and even. And then unfold it. You want to take the bottom left corner and fold it up to the top right corner. Make sure it's nice and even. Want it to be nice and as straight and even as possible. And you're going to unfold it. Then you're going to bring the left and right edges. Forward. Inwards kind of thing. So it shows up like that. Then you want to flatten it. Then you want to open it. So it's like that. Then you want to repeat the process for all six of them. Evenly as possible. All four folds. Then you want to take them and bring them in like before. And then flatten it. Just like that. In one moment. And so we got two of them now. Once you get all of them, you're going to slot them in place like this. It's probably better if you do this with smaller sheets of paper. But when you got them slotted in, you do that with all six sheets. Then you'll have a little fidget ball thing. Fidget everything is the new everything, right? So, why not, right? Just like that. You're gonna fold them in half. Remember, the more even your folds are, the better your product turns out to be in the end. So there's another one. You take the inner one, the other inner one, fold them inwards, and flatten it. And you just slot it into place like that. Three more to do. Come on. Here we go. And then you just slot it into the next one. We got two more left to do. The more square your sheets are, the more even these diagonal folds will turn out. So it's a good way to check to see if you cut your sheet nice and straight. See, I cut mine a little bit off. Just a little bit. And that's from the scissor slipping from cutting too many sheets at once. This and then this, I'm going to take fold it inwards again. There we go. There, we got another one. So we just slot that into there. Might need to get somebody to help you with this. There. got one left. Might be easier if you use a little bit of tape or something to help you put them in and hold them in place. Sheesh. There we go. Not quite. It slid. Darn it. Alright, whatever. That's okay. Doesn't have to be perfect with these ones. There we go. This one's trying to be extra difficult. That's okay. There. Now, we'll fold it backwards just to make this next one easier. I found on that last one I did, it was a lot easier to make it fold inwards when you did that. There. There we go. Fold it the other way here. Let's see. This is going to be difficult with only my hands doing it. Slot it in. Slot that one in. Oh, come on. Definitely gonna need help doing it. Oh, come on. Get one in and another one comes out. You know what? Let's see if I got some tape here or something somewhere. Here we go. I'm going to staple it together. It's all I could find, but I'm sure you could use tape or something else. Well, we might need staples. It just might help. Maybe we don't have staples. Or do I? Maybe I do. And finally, we fix one of these. It's not quite straight. There we go. Fix this one too, because it's not quite straight either. And there we go. The finished product. Staples worked actually pretty good for that. So if you're a child, get an adult to help you. Please like and subscribe for more videos like this. Thank you.